Alan in Elmwood Park. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning, Alan.
Morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. This is pretty pathetic that this is the third day you're talking about this battle land.
Yeah.
And trying to avoid having to defend your butt buddy, Donald Trump.
Wow, that's pretty negative. That's a little hostile, right. Alan. So let me understand. So the preservation of American history, the local Jersey critical nature that involves government, involves neighbors, that's not important. What's important is you want to hear me what? Defend Donald Trump on what?
No, I don't want you to defend him. You should defend him. You're the one who loves Donald Trump. By the way, how does that affect New Jerseyans in any possible way about a battlefield? How does that affect New Jerseyans in any possible way?
Well, Alan, let me explain it to you. So we're going to get a little education here. So the crossroads of the American Revolution took place. Well, I mean, Alan, you're being very negative. The crossroads of the American Revolution happened right here in New Jersey. So Washington's army, after so much time running around, foraging, trying to get this army together, keeping people from deserting, etc., all this stuff going on, they met the British regulars in Princeton and they won. And it was the turning point of the American Revolution. And if there's any value to history, and I'm going to watch me segue into the other conversation, other question. There's a value to history. And it's part of the reason that Donald Trump has been taken out of context. There is historical precedent, believe it or not, for what he's saying in terms of what we have done in America when MacArthur was overseeing Japan after the war and banning the Shinto religion because it was fostering radicals. There is a history, a rich history of our country's self-preservation that has come from dealing with our borders, dealing with radicals. Now, whether or not you think Donald Trump is inciting something that he shouldn't, I would say that the people that are inciting this animosity and anger toward Islam are terrorists. That's who's inciting the anger and animosity. And law enforcement, you heard Joe Jackalone earlier. So first of all, Alan, it's not even accurate. I've been talking about this all day. We had Joe Jackalone on, who was a New York City police detective, saying, hey, it's not helpful, you know, when you got a lot of this rhetoric, but law enforcement is ready. And if you listen to all the reports coming out of 9/11, when Rudy Giuliani was on CNN saying essentially Trump was not completely wrong about Muslim celebrations after 9/11 and during 9/11. If you heard him say that, he also said the New York City Police Department had to be deployed to protect American Muslims. So there are two sides to it. But to put all this on Donald Trump, I just think it's ignorant and short-sighted. And I hope you understand the value of American history and understanding history and certainly preserving a spot where someone died when you've got a vibrant real estate market that there is a huge alternative to what's going on now. All right, Alan. Go ahead. Hey, listen, I got to take a break for news, but thanks for calling. Meet me on Twitter. We'll continue the conversation at Bill Spadea.